Good day to you from ChemHelp ASAP. Let's use some of the diazonium chemistry that has been covered in earlier videos in this playlist. On the left is a molecule that we need to make. It's a benzene ring with a chloro and fluoro group pair it to one another. We know the only way to get a fluorine on a ring is through the diazonium chemistry. We also know that in order to have the groups para, the first group on the ring should be an orthopara director. So let's start by putting the chlorine on the ring and then do the fluorine. We start with benzene. We can put on the chlorine through our standard chlorination conditions. Now we have an ortho-para director in place. The next group will go para because ortho is more sterically hindered than para. That group will need to be a nitro group in order to set up the diazonium chemistry. So we'll treat the ring with HNO3 and H2SO4. To be careful with the chlorine, let's reduce the nitro with SNCl2 in ethanol. That gives us the aniline. Let's go to the next line. We'll treat the aniline with NaNO2 and HCl. To form the diazonium ion, we can finish the sequence with potassium tetrafluoroborate. And that will give us our final desired product. Two comments. One, we could have put on the fluorine first. As an ortho-para director, the chlorine would have then gone para. Comment number two, as tempting as it might be, there is no direct fluorination procedure like F2 and aluminum trifluoride. So don't try it. It won't work. All right, let's see another problem. Our target molecule is on the left. We have a methyl group and carboxylic acid group para on a ring. Since the groups are para, the first group on the ring needs to be an ortho-para director. Let's put the methyl on first. Start with benzene and perform a Friedel-Crafts alkylation with chloromethane. No problem. Now, how do we add the acid? One option is to add a nitrile and then hydrolyze it to a carboxylic acid. That approach requires the diazonium chemistry we learned in this playlist. So, nitrate the ring HNO3, H2SO4. The nitro goes para. Then make or reduce the nitro group that will give us our aniline. Go to the next line. Let's now make our diazonium. Use sodium nitrite and aqueous HCl. And finally, copper cyanide will convert the diazonium to the nitrile. Lastly, we'll treat this with water and some acid to get the carboxylic acid. So this would work fine. Now, there's a completely valid option that we could have also done. What if we instead had the bromide? We could make the Grignard, react that with CO2 to add a single carbon, and then add acid and water to protonate the carboxylic acid. Either method would work. So those are two aromatic synthesis problems that use diazonium ion chemistry to make the products.